I remember seeing Brian Trottier for the first time, and I guess this is probably why I didn't end up being a scout, because I was watching him on the ice and I said, this kid will never make it.
Brian Trottier was a true champion and could do it all.
He's not very tall at 5'9", but boy, he knows how to throw his weight around.
Could play physical, could skate, could score.
Every crucial situation, he's on the ice.
I really enjoyed the competition. I like to contribute in offense, and I probably took as much pride in the defensive zones.
Brian Trottier made his NHL debut with the New York Islanders in 1975. Scoring 32 goals and 95 points, he won the Calder Trophy as Rookie of the Year.
When he first broke into the league, he wasn't as big as some of the other guys. He made up for it with speed and agility and just did everything he needed to do to be successful.
The biggest key for my family was not to give an effort, it was to like, give your best effort, always.
He was probably one of the most consistent players that I've ever seen.
Brian is like the foundation of our team. He's the type of player that does everything well.
Hitting it, it's what's up, he scores! Coming from the side, scores! Brian Trottier.
Brian always wanted to be the best that there was out there.
Him and Boz bonded together, which was great. I mean, the two of them on the ice, you knew that they were going to score, and they scored a lot of big goals for us.
Trottier with Bossy, what more can you ask?
It looked like we were having fun, and we were having fun, but we were having fun because we were successful.
In 1978-79, just his fourth season, Trottier led the league in scoring with 47 goals and 134 points, winning the Art Ross and Hart trophies. The Islanders' young core seemed to get better every year.
The building up to the championships was fun. It was tough. We were a young team, and we finally kind of gelled there.
The New York Islanders won their first Stanley Cup in 1980. Trottier scored 29 points in the playoffs, earning the Conn Smythe Trophy.
I'll cherish this moment for the rest of my life.
The victory in 1980 marked the start of a dynasty for the Islanders. They went on to win again in 81, 82, and 83, making it four consecutive Stanley Cups.
We like that feeling of being a champion. As a group, I think we wanted to win, and I think that was our greatest asset. I think we all recognize the value of every player on the team, and I think that's what makes that run so special.
Thank God! Thank you, won it all!
Trottier left the Islanders in 1990 to sign with the Pittsburgh Penguins, at which point he had amassed six 100-point seasons, scoring 40 or more goals five times, including a career high of 50 in 1981-82.
Long Island was a wonderful place to win and have championships. It was like we gave Long Island an identity. And going to Pittsburgh, it was like fresh again. There was a renewed appreciation for what I was going to bring to Pittsburgh.
He was a guy that this team had never won the Cup, and he's coming in with four. Just confidence oozing out of him, and guys looked to him and definitely provided a tremendous amount of leadership.
He helped the young Penguins win back-to-back Stanley Cups in 91 and 92, retiring in 1994 as a six-time Stanley Cup champion.
But I think Brian Trottier, arguably, in my mind, was the best centerman that I think I may have ever seen.
To be plain and simple, if I was given the task to start a hockey team, Brian Trottier would be my number one centerman.